EPCAMR, Eastern Pennsylvania Coalition for Abandoned Mine Reclamation. I'd like to extend a warm welcome on this chilly morning to Secretary Haaland, Senator Casey, Congressman Cartwright, and Cindy Dunn from the Pennsylvania Department of Conservation and Natural Resources, among other dignitaries here today. Also, to the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection, Bureau of Abandoned Mine Reclamation, the Office of Surface Mining Reclamation and Enforcement, and Keystone Reclamation Fuels Management for the work on the Swoyersville project, in which EPCAMR is managing the grant. I grew up in the town of West Wyoming, 1 mile downwind from the abandoned Harry E. Coal Breaker, where we stand today. For years, these culm banks have been producing airborne coal dust as well as groundwater contaminants. As the leader of the free, civilized world, we cannot continue this legacy of pollution to our health and environment. How wonderful that these environmental issues that have plagued our area for so long are now being addressed. There is no commodity on this planet more precious than water. Water is life. Small headwater streams and wetlands are the capillaries of the watershed. They are the lifeblood of a healthy ecosystem. As an avid fly fisherman, you quickly learn that macroinvertebrates and native brook trout are the benchmark of the purity of a stream. We have so many dead streams, devoid of life, poisoned from acidic mine water and laced with heavy metals. These the three largest point sources of pollution of the Chesapeake Bay are here in Northeast Pennsylvania. The Old Forge borehole, Auden Reed Mine Tunnel, and Jetto Mine Tunnel, all pumping millions of gallons of mine water every day into streams that flow into the Susquehanna River and on into the Chesapeake Bay. These problems need to be addressed. The anthracite region powered the Industrial Revolution. Now it's time to take care of the blight that was left behind. Funding is needed to continue land reclamation, water quality improvements, and AMD cleanup so economic development can occur on these lands. This will strengthen the job market with career opportunities in alternative energy, like the solar arrays on AMD land project being piloted by EPCAMR, cutting-edge technology of rare earth elements and nanoparticle extraction, and geothermal heating from mine water. We at EPCAMR are passionate about reclamation, AMD cleanup, clean air, and clean water. EPCAMR is a leader and has been doing incredible work for 20 years. And with our partners, we will continue to break ground, promoting these innovative technologies and continuing with the massive AMD cleanups in the Susquehanna and Delaware River watersheds. Thank you, Secretary Haaland. We are thrilled you are here today touring these sites in our region. We look forward to showing you what we have achieved from the funding we have received. We are devoted to making these lands better than when we inherited them. And with your help, we hope to achieve our goal of clean and green Pennsylvania. Thank you.
We're going to see several abandoned mine land sites today that are in various stages of the reclamation process. Some have been reclaimed and are no longer polluting the neighboring waterways and homes. Some, like the giant coal pile behind me and the one that we saw from the top, are about to see an infusion of funding to help ensure that no one has this kind of pollution sitting in their backyards any longer. Pennsylvania represents approximately 46% of the United States' remaining reclamation costs. We cannot ignore this legacy pollution, and right here in Pennsylvania is where we can make a major difference. Thankfully, in partnership with many of the folks you see here today, the Biden-Harris administration is already working to take action. The bipartisan infrastructure law, recently signed by the president and passed by the House and the Senate, and I thank you all again for supporting that, makes an $11.3 billion investment in cleaning up abandoned mine lands. With that funding, folks will be able to reclaim areas like this behind me for recreational facilities and other economic redevelopment as we improve local water quality and reduce flooding. And it's for the kids, right? Later today, we'll also visit sites that demonstrate how infrastructure law investments will build clean energy projects on current and former mine lands, use mine waste for electricity generation, and protect local waterways. Today, we're also excited to announce that Interior will allow states and tribes to use grant funds from the bipartisan infrastructure law to design, build, operate, maintain, and rehabilitate acid mine drainage treatment facilities, a new infusion of money to clean up our rivers and streams in a way that wasn't possible before the law was signed. We cannot address legacy pollution without dealing with polluted waters. This funding will be crucial to removing toxic metals from our waters and returning fish and wildlife to waterways that have been devoid of life for decades. These historic investments are all part of the administration's all-of-government approach to supporting communities as they address the lingering impacts of extractive industries and transition to a clean energy future. Central to that transition is creating jobs. And these funds will support vitally needed jobs for coal communities by funding all types of reclamation projects. And once these sites are cleaned up, they become part of the foundation for a new economic development opportunities. We look forward to working with the state of Pennsylvania to get these funds out the door and deliver results for these communities. It's important that as we move forward, we're doing it with a focus on equity and inclusion to make sure that all communities have a seat at the table as these investments get to the places where they're needed most. Together, we'll make the smart investments that we need to build a cleaner energy, to build a cleaner and more just future for our children and grandchildren. Thank you all so much again for being here, and I believe we are happy to take some questions.